Now, let's talk about some science. We have a fun activity to create art for your youngest artists. West 2's Jacqueline D'Agostino shows us the neat project with our friends at the Orlando Science Center.
Hey everyone, we are back at the Orlando Science Center for another edition of The Science of It. I'm hanging out with my friend Tori, and Tori, tell us what we're doing today with all this stuff.
All right, so today we're gonna be making some really cool art creations. These are called frescoes, and we're gonna be running a really cool workshop in the Kidstown studio brought to us by the Cornelia Bailey Foundation. We received a grant that we're so grateful for and we're so excited to share. This kind of art form is similar to some of the art pieces we will have in our Pompeii exhibit. That'll be our blockbuster exhibit. So it's kind of going to be a bridge between for early childhood audience to understand some of the art pieces that are in that exhibit. So frescoes themselves are an art form where you're combining pigment, like whatever kind of paints you would like to use, with plaster. Traditionally, it's going to be very wet plaster, but we're going to do it in a little bit less messier of a version just to be able to do it with our early childhood audience. So first, we're going to need to prepare our blanks for this project. So okay. I'm going to go ahead and give you this mixing bowl here.
Perfect.
And then we're going to use a ratio of 2 parts plaster to 1 part water. So I've already pre-measured out 2 cups of plaster for you and 1 part water.
Okay.
Go ahead and take that whisk out and combine those ingredients into that bowl.
And they have to go at the same time?
It doesn't matter. Okay. Go right ahead.
So that's the plaster.
The plaster, yeah. So they're just going to start to combine once you pour that water in there. And we're going to look for a smooth consistency so that we have a nice smooth blank to work
with.
There you go.
Ooh. And then we're just whisking it together.
Yeah, so it's gonna start to cloud up a little bit and you can go ahead and whisk it together. It doesn't have to be too fast or anything, just less chunks is better, ideally.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it's kind of thick, right?
Yeah, okay. You're gonna have to work with it a little bit and it'll start to like combine nice and smooth.
Okay, oh my gosh.
Yeah, there you go.
That's
why we have aprons on today. So we're gonna prep this step ahead of time for the workshops, but we still have to go through the process to kind of get the full scope of what these frescoes are for us.
I really thought I'd be better at whisking. I don't really.
It's kind of an awkward thing. It's not like dough or any like making cookies or cooking in the kitchen.
Okay. I think it looks pretty good. What do you think?
Okay. Yeah, I'll take a look.
I feel like it looks a little smooth.
Yeah, that looks pretty good.
Cool.
So if you want to set this down here in the middle of it, you can leave the whisk in there. That's totally cool. And then you're going to want to bring, we're going to have cardboard on the bottom, burlap on the top, and then the plaster is going to kind of like seep through the bottom of this burlap, and then they'll kind of all stay together and it'll help us like work with it a little easier. So I'll go ahead and give you this spatula.
Perfect.
And go ahead and take a couple scoops out of this bowl, and you're going to put it right onto your burlap there.
That's good right there.
Yeah, just as many, we'll probably have to do 4 or 5 scoops just to kind of get enough to make a good circle.
There you go. Oh my gosh. I'm a hot mess right now. So this will harden and then it'll make this stick together.
So the wet plaster will kind of go through the like little gaps in the burlap and it'll kind of transfer to the cardboard a little bit.
Gotcha.
Yeah, it looks pretty good. So what you're going to do is kind of push on the middle and then kind of smooth it outward. And you can go back and forth as much as you need. And you'll be able to kind of make the blank. I've had a lot more practice with this, so don't worry.
I was like, whoa.
I've made so many of these in preparation for our workshop.
And so do you want to get it super, like more thick, or does it?
Even is better. As evenly distributed as possible. If they're too thick, sometimes they're pretty hard to, we're gonna do a step later that you'll see, one way or the other. I don't wanna give it away.
Right. I feel like my circle could be better, but you know.
That's okay, they don't have to be perfect. That looks good to me.
Abstract as well.
So if you wanna set yours off to the side, we actually have some that I've prepared ahead of time.
Awesome.
So here is your blank.
Thank you.
Here's my blank. And so what we're gonna do is just kind of, I'm gonna spritz the plaster a little bit to keep the chalk from the pastels down a little bit.
Okay.
Go ahead and do that to yours as well. Great. All right, and then you're gonna use these pastels to make whatever creation you would like.
Okay.
These pastels do blend super well, and you can use this rag too if you need to kind of clear off your fingers when you're blending. So whatever you'd like to make, you can draw it however on your blank here, and then we're gonna do another step afterward.
Okay.
So I'm probably gonna go with something easy like a flower.
I think I'm gonna do a rainbow, but let's see.
All right, lots of colors, I like
lots
it.
Lots of colors.
And when we do the workshop, we're gonna allow the children to do it along with their grown-ups and see how they can like kind of work together to blend these colors. All the colors are blending nice.
Perfect.
And smooth. Yep, there we go.
Okay,
so you're gonna pick up your blank, and if it's stuck to the cardboard a little bit, that's okay. There you go. And you're gonna crack it. So we're gonna create that effect that makes it look old. We have some examples here. If you wanna look at it, reference how they kind of crack instead of the pieces split out, it's okay if they do. It makes it look older.
Okay.
So go ahead and crack it as many times. Ooh. There you go. And we're hoping the kiddos have a lot of fun with this step.
Just breaking stuff for fun.
And making it look really old and historic, like the pieces that are gonna be in our Pompeii exhibit. Because of course it is from way, way, way back when.
Right.
All right, and then I've kind of cracked mine a pretty good amount. Okay. All right, and now we're gonna use some glue to kind of seal in our, so I'll pour it like kind of right in the middle and I'll let you do yours.
Oh wow, okay.
Yeah, pretty generous amount so that we're sealing all the colors in because they do kind of smear around. So this will kind of seal them in.
Okay.
And go ahead and use that scraper and you'll kind of smear it all around. And it'll kind of seal in the cracks a little bit.
And it almost like sort of blends it. Like I feel like my color's kind of spreading a little bit with the glue.
Yeah, they're gonna kind of form together a little better. All right, whenever you're done, you can set that off to the side.
Yeah, that's
where all the glue are.
Very satisfying.
Cool, and then so at this point, we would box up these frescoes for our workshop participants and they would take it home. And then later it's gonna get all dried and then they can cut the burlap off and then they kind of look like these pieces we have here. So this is just like another example. Oranges are very iconic at the Science Center for our Orange Grove in Kidstown. So they're gonna kind of look like this and they can hang them up at home.
Awesome.
But yeah, they're just, it's our fresco workshop, again, brought to us by the Cornelia Bailey Foundation for the grant that we received. We're very excited for our Pompeii exhibit and we think this is gonna be a really fun thing to do with the kiddos for it.
Awesome, thank you so much, Tori. And that does it for us for another edition of The Science of It.
So if you wanna see what other cool stuff is happening at the Orlando Science Center, it's open every day from 10 to 5 through January 24th.